Hello everybody, we've Coach Bradley here today. He's going to share a little bit of De La Riva, going to Burn Bowlers, okay? And so throughout the week, he's going to share all his tricks with us. All right, Coach Bradley.
All right guys, so we're going to do a little bit of De La Riva. It's also known as your outside hook guard. So basically, what is that? I'm going to be seated here, like any guard. When you're on your back, you're going to try to keep your hips off the mat and your head off the mat. Now, the most important thing about De La Riva is obviously this outside hook, okay? So, I'm gonna make a grip here on the collar. We're gonna talk a little bit about the grips later. Basically, my left leg here is on the outside and it's gonna hook the inside of the professor's thigh here, all right? Now, the job of this hook is to make sure his knee doesn't start rotating this side of my belt, okay? So, it's not so much the hook that's important here, more the pressure you can put on his knee with the hook, all right? So that's probably the most important thing about De La Riva. Now we get into controls with our hands. So ideally, probably the best control you can get here is a really, really deep grip on the collar, almost so your palm is facing up, okay? This is really, really hard to break. So you kind of want to gripping palm facing up and then just curl your wrist in a little bit. The reason you curl your wrist in, drops your elbow down so it's harder for him to duck his head out, okay? Now, second grip, you're just going to grab the ankle here. This is probably the most common grips you're gonna see in De La Riva. Now, the job of my collar grip is to try to keep his head off his hips. If his head's in front of his toes, his base is a little bit compromised and also puts more weight on the leg I'm controlling, means I can use that to his disadvantage, right? So here's your basic grips. Now, what's common, especially if you've kind of pulled guard here, he's trying to posture up, you might not be able to get this super deep grip behind the net. That's all right. As long as you can get a grip above the G on his uniform, it's pretty strong. It's just a little bit easier for Marcus here to use his generic grip breaks, boom, get his posture up, okay? Now, the other grip I can have on my hand, doesn't have to be on the collar, you can grip here on the sleeve. Now, I'm not controlling where his head is as well here, but I can start crossing his arm. Very powerful in the De La Riva guard to start attacking the back, and obviously anytime you can cross their arm across your body, back attack's available. So that's kind of your third grip here. Now, grips with my hands, all right? Most common one here, just grabbing the ankle. Advantage of this, I can start pulling a little bit, turning his knee. So remember how I said at the start, if his knee starts turning out to the right here, my hook's gonna get weak, and pop out, okay? So using this hand to turn the knee just helps me a little bit here. So that's one grip, all right? Now, maybe you're versing someone quite a bit stronger than you, or maybe they're thrashing around a bit and you just need to control them. This grip isn't the best for control. The grip I would turn to is gripping here on the pants, all right? Remember guys, you can't go inside, gotta be on the outside. Now, disadvantage of this, very hard for me to control knee rotation with my hand. I'm only relying on my hook here. That's all right though. But here, it's very, very hard for Professor to free his leg that I'm controlling. Lastly, the grip you can use on the ankle is going all the way through and just hugging on the inside of your thigh. Now, the advantage of this is a lot of control, and I'm starting to threaten the deep De La Riva to his back here. Disadvantage, my back starts coming off the mat, and it makes it quite a bit easier for him to leg drag me here. Okay, so you gotta watch that when you're going through here. If you notice that they're really, really trying to leg drag here, try to throw your deep De La Riva in straight away, because if they do cross the leg now, it's quite easy to just enter your baby bowlers, all right? So that's just the controls, guys. Let's just go over one more time super quick. Maybe switch the side. So, outside hook on the inside, hooking the fly. Remember, don't be so concerned about having a hook. The most important job here is that you're controlling his rotation. So even if his posture is lower here and my hook is out, I can still control knee rotation by driving my knee in, okay? Now, let's talk about the free leg here on this side. You see it a little bit better, all right? So we went through all our grips. With our right hand, our left hand, this leg's quite important, okay? So, general rule, my heel shouldn't pass to this side of his body. If it does, he's entering leg drags, your De La Riva's done, okay? So, you need to keep it on this side of the belt. where should you put it? If you have shorter legs, it's probably better to leave it higher here on the groin. Reason being, if you kick away and create a disconnection, you're no longer controlling the leg. So if you were to go lower and you had shorter legs and I kicked away, you create a disconnection, you can start stepping over, entering these passes. If you have longer legs, you can definitely afford to go a little bit lower because you can buckle his knee a little bit when you kick away, gives you a little bit better control. Now, the third spot you can put your foot is up here on the shoulder, okay? When you put the foot on the shoulder, make sure you're locking your heel in. In my opinion, this is the most dangerous to get leg dragged here. So you really need to be conscious of this leg if you're gonna leave it up here on the shoulder, all right? So those are just some of your basic controls from De La Riva. You need to have those down because you're not gonna be able to enter your attacks if your De La Riva is weak, because they're just gonna get out straight away and they're just gonna pass. Thanks, guys.